FEMA has estimated that it will take roughly 5 years to reconstruct the whole island.
8 years or maybe more, because we are 78 cities. We are 78 cities.
A decade.
Maybe it's a decade.
This is a country where we speak English, not Spanish.
You need to make sure your child can speak Spanish.
Dr. Maria Melendez, or Mayita, is one of the 78 mayors in the Caribbean island of Puerto Rico.
Wow, we have water and food to give to
everyone. In 2009, she made history by becoming the first female mayor in the city of Ponce. Before that, she used to be a dental surgeon for over 3 decades. That's how she really bonded with the people. Let's fast forward to 2017 and you find Mayita among the first responders after Hurricane Maria struck Puerto Rico. I mean, she was even awarded a medal for it. Saying that she's a voice or a leader to her community can be an understatement. Maybe some see her as a hero. Perhaps this is why she's earned the nickname Lady Lion.
Ponce has a symbol, is the lion. It was conquered by Ponce de Leon, a Spanish conqueror. I fight for my people, I work for my people, I passionate for my people, and doing serving for the people. So they call me Lady Lion.
You know, one thing that astounds me is that a lot of people here in this country still don't know or are unaware that Puerto Ricans are, in fact, US citizens. Why do you think that is?
People have to be educated, and we have to tell them. We are a territory, a Commonwealth territory. We're not a state. We are not independent. We don't have any person who represent us in Congress, only a voice in Congress, the resident commissioner, Jennifer Gonzalez, in the House of Representatives. So she doesn't have a vote. Now, after the devastation of the Hurricane Maria, we began to raise our voices and be vocal about what happened in Puerto Rico and what's happening in Puerto Rico. And we came here, the governor came, now they know that we are American citizens.
So is it fair to say that the schools are not doing a good job?
I would prefer to say they have to do a better job. When they teach history, they have to tell who conquered who.
You mentioned the hurricane. 2017 was particularly devastating for the island. The hurricane wiped out everything, not to mention a spike in crime. I don't want to focus on the negatives, but how does this affect the current debt situation in Puerto Rico? Can there be any positives?
There are many things that have to be positive. First of all, the alliance that we have made in doing business, the alliance that we have made with the United States, and also after that, we understood that Puerto Rico has to be reconstructed and Puerto Rico has to be modernized.
That's perfect. You're making it hard for me. So what do you think is the future for the actual economy?
The positive things are, and the good things and the economic basis is that even though we are in a financial crisis, we are doing things that change the way of doing business, one of the things. The other one, the revenues, we have to lower them also because we are open to incentive to the people. But we have to receive, and that's important. But the thing is that the central government and the oversight board who is working it was because of the financial crisis have to know that municipalities are well prepared and can manage federal funding because, for example, I have a whole transportation system, public transportation system, that is free. It's free for the people. I have Head Start schools for my kids. They're free for them. But that things have funding. Those things have been validated in studies and presentations in financial area. And they, what they do is raise certificates and give up more money. So in federal funding, the Congress have to know and the Treasury Department have to know that we municipality can manage the economy also.
Yeah.
Random 4.